The ongoing investigation into child sex abuse allegations against Jerry Sandusky leads to more delays in the trial process. Today's courtroom developments are the top story on News 8 at Noon. Good afternoon. I'm Susan Shapiro. Today's hearing was supposed to address major issues, including whether the charges against Sandusky should be dropped. But that's not what happened. News 8's Matt Barcaro was in the courtroom in Center County this morning and has more on the proceedings. Good afternoon, Matt.
Good afternoon, Susan. This hearing was supposed to be essentially a make or break moment for Sandusky's defense team. The trial is scheduled to begin 2 months from today, but the Sandusky's lead attorney, Joe Amendola, he withdrew his request to dismiss the case, at least for now. Jerry Sandusky was at the hearing, though. He showed up. His attorney said that is because they wanted to show that Sandusky is still very much involved in the case, but he did not talk while he was going into the courthouse or when he was in the courtroom. This was a relatively quick proceeding, less than a half an hour. Amendola decided that now is not the time to try to drop the case. That's because the prosecution is still investigating, and they're still bringing in new evidence. So he wants to wait until all that evidence is in to make that motion. So not a lot happened in court, but it was very different outside the courtroom. You can see there's a podium out there. That's where the attorneys speak after the court hearings usually. And the lead prosecutor is usually very laid back and stoic, but today he lashed out at Amendola, saying that this hearing is an example of something that's lengthy and pointless.
When the day before the preliminary hearing, I told the defendant and counsel that I was ready to proceed on all charges, all counts, all victims. He elected not to hear that testimony. He will hear it one day and we'll be ready.
We've been trying to overcome this tidal wave of presumption of guilt since November 5th. And so we've had to come out and do things that maybe ordinarily in a typical case we wouldn't do, so that you folks know and the general public knows Mr. Sandusky has always maintained his innocence. Mr. Sandusky intends to go to trial and present his side to this case, and that we have a defense.
So what happens now? That's what a lot of people are asking. The judge made it clear that he still wants this trial to start on June 5th. That's when jury selection will begin. So now there's a new deadline for Amendola to file those motions to dismiss the case. That is May 16th. He's still waiting for all the evidence to come in. That's also the cutoff date for when the investigation into these charges involving Jerry Sandusky have to stop and then the trial can start. Susan.
All right. We shall see. Thank you, Matt.